Hey Sean, Chance here, and I'm going to do a quick battle plan for September 7th, Friday, and I'm going to do it on /ES, which is the S&P 500, and the other indices that you can find on NADEX. And tomorrow's Friday, and I have said this every single Thursday night for the last 4 years, okay? You need to understand that Friday is an extremely, extremely psychological and mental day for a trader. And what I mean by that is you cannot be doing anything stupid on Fridays and lose money, because if you do, you then have 2 days to think and sulk over your losses. And as a trader, you just can't do that to yourself mentally. And so Friday for you should always be a very light day. We've had just an incredible, awesome week. The daily candle sell trigger showed its teeth. It was beautiful. I told you that was coming. And so with volatility has picked up. And so going into Friday, you normally you would trade, you know, till about 11, 12 o'clock Eastern, then just shut it down, stop trading. And then on Fridays, I always like the quote, when in doubt, stay out, right? You cannot be losing money on Fridays. And if you feel like you're not in the flow, feel like you don't have any edges, just stay the heck out so that you can go on the weekend on a high note, okay? And so I'm going to start here on /ES. And like I said, the daily candle sell trigger was perfect. We made our way into that middle blue Keltner, and we made our way back to equilibrium. And so yes, this daily candle sell trigger definitely has more room to continue grinding lower. And so we could possibly see a massive Friday dump. So be prepared for that. May have some -1.5 or -2 deviation plays tomorrow if we do see a massive Friday dump. A lot of dumps actually happen on Fridays. I'm not sure why or what the reason for that is. But I've been doing this a long time. Dumps, most of the, when you get a large dump, a lot of the days it's Friday. And so when we look at that daily chart, we're at equilibrium. But when we start looking at the 4-hour chart, you can see how now we're starting to get oversold. Now, does that mean that this can't continue going lower? Of course not, right? Market can do whatever it wants to do. But the 4-hour chart is getting oversold, coming into some decent structure. And so pretty much if this ES continues grinding lower, the more oversold it's going to get, and we can look for higher low buy triggers, and we'll find those zones here on the smaller time frames. But this chart does have lots of room to grind back higher tomorrow, and so we could possibly see, you know, this 4-hour candle buy trigger really showing its teeth tomorrow, and we could, and absolutely, I could be looking for some retracement sell triggers as well. So now we built that story on the daily chart. We see the 4-hour chart starting to get oversold. We now move to the 15-day, 15-minute plot chart. What I'm doing here is I'm just looking for structure. I'm looking for the best places to buy, the best places to sell. I'm looking for support, resistance, supply, and demand zones. And what I always do is I start exactly where price is, and then I start planning and visualizing what am I going to do or not do if this chart starts grinding higher tomorrow. I got to have a plan in place for every single zone, and then what am I going to do or not do if this chart starts grinding lower tomorrow. Okay, so let's first talk about if we grind higher. We know that 4-hour chart's oversold. We know the 1-hour chart's oversold. We know there could be quite a bit of bias to this upside from that from those charts cycling back up, right? And so we could, so my first resistance sell zone would be off of that +0.5. There's some really good change control there, but when we look at that 4-hour chart, let me go back to it. With that 4-hour chart, if it starts gunning, it's gonna wanna run back up into this zone here, which that's gonna put us here to here, right? So just be mindful that an example, this is important to understand this stuff. We look for a sell trigger here, and it continues going higher. And you cry and you lose, right? Well, hey, it's just the 4-hour chart continuing its cycle to the upside, right? So it's important to understand the cycles. And that's why, yes, this isn't a horrible place to sell, but you just need to understand that you could get whipsawed from that 4-hour chart continuing to grind higher. And then the second sell zone would be right there, +1. I'm not against 2900 because it's a big round number and there is some good change control there, but again, it's Friday, so I don't want to be just forcing stupid stuff. If I see a decent like that would have to be like a carrot trade, get in and get out because you don't want to be holding a sell trade right there for too long because that 4 hour chart could continue gunning on you, right? And then of course my second sell zone would be the plus one. So a little bit trickier if we run higher. You just got to make sure that you understand the cycles. And so if you want to look at the 1 hour chart cycle here, where's the top of the 1 hour chart cycle? You can see the top is roughly about that 2095 would be the top of the 1 hour chart cycle. And so that would be pretty darn close right into our plus 0.5 deviation. So it's important to just to understand the cycles. It'll really, really help you not get ran over. Okay. And so we know how crazy over, not crazy, but we are getting oversold. So the lower we go, I can be looking for quick buy triggers. My first one would be that negative and a half. And then if this chart wants to dump tomorrow, we are going to have a negative one. And then if we continue dumping, right, you always want to make sure that you're buying higher lows, especially on a Friday, especially with the daily chart volatility picking up. So if you're not seeing higher lows and you're not seeing higher lows and it continues gunning about 13 more points to the downside, so 2840-ish is going to be our negative one and a half, and then another 28 or 2827 is going to be our negative two. So you always just want to make sure that as if we grind lower tomorrow, that you're waiting for proper change control before you enter. Wait for, and if you're wondering what that is, I have so many videos free on YouTube that teaches you how to find that proper change control before you buy. Okay. Now I want to quickly show you slash NQ has been getting hammered. Really, really coming back into some good structure. I want to show you slash NQ on the bird's eye view so you can kind of see what's going on here. When we look at that 4 hour chart, it really, really, really took off, as you can see, and we're almost back. It almost made it back to that big round 7,400, but it just missed it. And so we had that 4 hour candle buy trigger. It's trying to show some teeth. I actually caught a buy trigger on the 7,400. Sorry, I caught a buy trigger on the NASDAQ today. It went down to the negative one and a half. And so I caught a buy trigger off of that. So when you really look at this, it is oversold, but it does gonna it absolutely it can run right back to this demand down here, 7,400 for tomorrow. And so when we start looking at this, okay. We grind higher, first resistance sell zone right off that plus 0.5, the second one right there, plus one Thursday POC. We grind lower, first buy zone, value rate low, negative and a half, good change control to the left. And then the second one would be that negative one. And then you can do the math tomorrow to get the negative one and a half or the negative twos. I don't anticipate this chart going to negative one and a half, negative twos, because you can see we've had 2 days dump. It's rare to get a third day dump, but if we do, I may just screw it, let the chart do its thing. It's Friday. When bears dump on a Friday, it's tough. It's really, really tough. I guess my point is when bears dump on Fridays, they can continue to go, a lot lower than what you think, right? And so just whatever you do, please don't do anything stupid. And when in doubt, just stay the heck out. Slash RTY is actually really compacted into some good structure here. I don't like that plus 0.5. So if I were to look for sell triggers, it would have to be that valuary high Thursday plus one. As far as demand, negative and a half. And then guess what we have tomorrow that I have been telling you about for over a week? 1700. Right, we could possibly see that tomorrow. So if these bears want to start running, I can use 1710, 17 negative and a half as the breakout lower high, and I can run this chart back to 1700, where this we have a huge, huge magnet on 1700. We had a spike off of 1700. I've been getting you ready for this, and then yes, I can look for buy triggers off of that 1700 as well. And then -1.5, -2s. If you need it, you can calculate those, okay? So message me if you have any questions. Take pictures of all of your trades and post them in the group and in the chat room so that you can get feedback from me and from others.